Robert Coons with First Endurance. I'm here with Mary Beth Ellis, who had an amazing season this year, winning 3 Ironmans in an 8-week period. Now we're here at Kona, just 2 days away from race, and we're going to ask Mary Beth a couple questions about race day. First, on those 3 Ironmans, how'd you do it over 8 weeks? How were you able to train, recover, train, and race?
You know, the first Ironman we hit pretty hard and tried to race that one well, and then the second one was a bit more low-key, and then the third one again was a tough race. And I think what's made the difference, besides obviously taking the time to rest, is I was talking to you earlier, I've been on the Multi-V and the Optigen, and I mean, that's kept me healthy all year. I mean, I haven't really been sick this year like I had been in years past. And in 2010, I spent a lot of the year overtrained, and I think, you know, this year just taking that every day has helped. And then obviously during the race, trying to get in as much fuel as possible. You know, the first few were a bit touch and go. I think I would overfuel and then have to let the stomach rest and kind of had some issues. But the third race, I didn't have any stomach issues at all. Just a little bit of heat issue, but no stomach issues.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about your race nutrition and exactly what you're doing. So you've learned from your 3 races kind of what works. You've tweaked things a little bit. Tomorrow is Friday. Do you do anything special on your diet on Friday?
Normally I wouldn't, but I think with this race I'll try to have a little bit more electrolytes and fluids than I would normally. Just try to get all the muscles just full of fluid, so feel a little bloated, but hopefully just try to get as much fluid on board as I can for Saturday.
Okay, and then you wake up Saturday morning. What time are you waking up?
Probably about 3 hours before the start, so probably around like 3:30.
3:30, so an early start, and then you have, what do you have for breakfast then?
For breakfast, I'll just sip on a little EFS drink, coffee, and probably make some egg whites, so have some toast and egg whites, and maybe also just an extra few pieces of toast, and that's about it.
Okay, and are you sipping on anything as you're getting ready for the swim?
Probably not. I'll probably just have water up until, I'll usually keep fueling with the drink up until maybe hour and a half, 2 hours before, and then just stick with water right up until the start. And won't have anything until I get out of the swim, and then right on my bike I'll have 3 bottles of EFS drink.
So do you put 2 scoops in each bottle? So roughly 600 calories is what you're starting the bike with?
Starting the bike with that, and then I'll have more bottles at my special needs.
Okay, and you're using just the powder, or do you use some liquid shot in there too? Are you carrying a liquid shot? What are you doing?
I don't use the liquid shot until the run, so I'll have 2 of those in my run transition bag and just start the run with both of those and take those as needed. And then this year with the WTC's letting us have drinks out there too, so probably just mix some cheap, probably use disposable bottles in case I don't get them back, but and put them in the freezer. So I was thinking about just mixing up some drink and freezing it, and then dropping those off race morning. So we'll have drink stations, I think 5 of them total.
On the run.
Mm-hmm.
So on the bike, your entire calories are EFS, or will you grab something from some of the aid stations and see, are you taking any solids in during the bike?
I might have, I've had gum, like just candy, basically gummy candy most races, just to kind of keep a little bit of extra sugar in, especially sometimes, you know, I just can't keep up with just drinking, so have a little bit extra. And then some races too, I've also just taken basic salt, extra salt on board. And then if I lose any of my bottles, I'll take stuff from the aid stations, just, you know, kind of be flexible, because sometimes I have 2 in the back, so if they pop off, you know, take aid as needed.
And like you mentioned, new to Kona this year is that the pros get their own aid stations, 5 of them on the run.
Mm-hmm.
So on that point, you'll have some liquid shots there, or you're going to have water bottles with EFS, or?
I think we're only allowed to have drink bottles. So
drink bottles.
Yeah, I'll probably have EFS drink at least 3 or 4 of them, and then maybe Coke at 1 of them, just to, if I need that little pick-me-up, just straight sugar. Yeah, but that, I think that's the plan, and freeze them so that hopefully they'll still be a little cold by the time I get to them.
Okay, great. Well, Mary Beth, thank you again. You know, Kona, obviously, it's the World Championships. You've won 3 Ironmans this year. I think it'd be a tall order to have you win again, but we hope the best for you. I hope that maybe you can make that happen. But
that would be a dream come true, but I'll be happy as long as I have a good race out there.
Yeah, of course, of course. Thanks again.